Hello and welcome to the learning video on flipped classroom implementation. Today we are going to discuss about the TPACK requirements for out of class activity. I am Dr. Payal Dande from SPKN's in MMS School of Pharmacy and Technology Management, Shirpur campus. Let us quickly have a look on the learning objectives. After watching this video, one should be able to learn about the various technological, pedagogical and content knowledge that is required to create an out-of-class activity under flipped classroom. Beside this, we are going to discuss about the do's and don'ts that we need to take care of while creating an out-of-class activity under flipped classroom. So first, we will see about the content requirements. Content requirements can be divided into two parts, one which we have to give before the class and another which we have to give after the class. So let us first discuss about before the class requirements. So before the class, we need to understand which topic would we like to cover in the out of class activity. What are the major key concepts that we want to cover? How many inclusions which we will make? And what are the major learning hours which are allotted to that topic? But the most important thing which we need to remember as a teacher is, what are the learning objectives and learning outcome that we are expecting from this flipped classroom? So the whole pedagogy and the technology will be driven by this two important aspect. That is, what is the learning objectives and learning outcomes that we are expecting from the students. Later, you can also add additional reference reading in the form of learning extensions. And you can also prepare some learning by doing activities and assignments which will reconfirm the understanding of the students. This is the content requirement which a teacher needs to make before the class. Now let us see what is required after the class. After the class, the teacher is expected to create some important major assignments that can elicit the higher cognitive skills in the students related to the practical application of the concept. Let us see the pedagogical requirements that is required for out of class activities. As I said, the pedagogical requirement will be driven by the learning objective and the learning outcome. So that will decide on the hierarchy of learning objectives. Step by step, we'll move on. For example, today I started with flipped classroom. First, I talked about what is flipped classroom. Then I told why we should use flipped classroom. Then I suggested when to use flipped classroom. And finally, now I am telling you how to use it. So similarly, these are nothing but the stepwise hierarchy of learning objectives. Similarly, you should also know what are the prior knowledge, what is the prior knowledge which you are expecting, which should be there in the students in the form of requirements so that their learning is made easier. The next important thing is teaching learning technique. You have to decide on a particular strategy or a method which you are going to use in order to teach a particular content. For example, over here we have used flipped classroom as the teaching learning technique or as a strategy. In flipped classroom, we all know that there are two parts: out of class activity, which is related or which is majorly for disseminating the information, and then there is in class activity, which is to practice the active learning. Further, we also need to, as a teacher, we also need to know the evaluation objective. What we want to understand, is it the reaction of the students which we want to evaluate? Is it the learning which is made by the students that we need to evaluate? The application part, the creating abilities, what exactly do we need to evaluate in terms of learning outcome? So based on the evaluation objective, we are going to select the evaluation techniques. For example, you can take a feedback if you want to know if your learning strategy was good or bad. You can even use survey for the same. Whereas you can give assignments when you want to check the learning, the theoretical knowledge of the students. If you want to check the application knowledge, you should give some important problems based on the concept. And if you want to know the creating abilities of the student, then you should give some resource creation assignment to them. So this is how we decide on the pedagogical requirements that will be there for the out-of-class activities. Now let us talk about the technological requirements for the out-of-class activities. Over here, the selection of technological requirement will completely be based on the content and pedagogy, meaning it will be content driven as well as the method which you have chosen. So there are various technologies which you can use. I have just listed few. For example, you may require internet, computer, printers, online learning management systems, content management systems, YouTube, video creation, editing tools, Windows, PowerPoint, and so on. Now, how will you decide which technological requirement or which technology will you use for the out-of-class activity? This depends on what you want to give. For example, if you want to distribute handouts, then you may require computer, printer, and copy machine. If you want to give soft copies, then you may require internet facilities. If you want to prepare your own video, that is learning audio visual videos in the form of lecture, then you may require video creation tools. You may also require video editing tools. You will require PowerPoint to make the screencast. Beside this, you can also have a wise idea of using the learning videos which are already available online in the educational website. But make sure they have Creative Commons license. So this is known as curating, that is selecting the correct online educational learning videos for disseminating the information. Beside this, a very important tool which will help you in managing everything is learning management system. So it will help you to disseminate the lectures, track the student visit, progress, create tests, evaluate the assignment, and also manage all the records. Beside this, YouTube, you can upload all your learning videos for mass dissemination on YouTube, and this link can be provided in one of the learning management system which you are going to use. So let us see what are the major video creation tools which are available. So there are some tools which are available as free, some as paid, and some as the basic model as free, and later the higher order model is being paid. So I've given you some names over here. The one which I'm using right now is Screencast-O-Matic. You can also use video editing tools like Windows Movie Maker, based on whether you have Windows, Linux, or Mac, whatever you are using, and whichever is compatible, you can actually select from here. These are some of the learning management systems. Some of them are free, some of them are paid, and some of them are free and paid both. So you, for those who do not have the learning management system, a paid one in their college, they can use Moodle and Genomeo. We over here are using Genomeo. So this is about the learning management system. Now that you are very clear about the pedagogical requirement, the content knowledge, and the technological requirement which is required for the creating the out of class activity for a flipped classroom, I want you to take a pause over here. Take 5 minutes and think, which technology and pedagogy will you like to use to teach course content of your specialization, and justify why. Come up with your choice and justify how it will help to teach the particular concept more effectively. Write your answer with justification and post it on our Moodle with your details in the discussion forum. Okay, having done this, now the most important part, the do's and don'ts of creating an out-of-class activity. So remember, if you are making your own learning video or you are selecting it from the websites, the educational website, one should be able to match it with the content which you want to teach to the students. Similarly, make sure that only one concept is being discussed at a time. The video should be brief, focused, clear, and easy to understand. Similarly, the time duration should be kept as far as possible 6 to 8 minutes, but of course 10 to 15 minutes are also permissible, provided they are not boring. It should also have reflection spot like what we had just now in the form of small assignments, which will reconfirm for the participants. Like for example, when participants use this, when the audience use this, they will come to know the whether they are being able to understand the topic. And most importantly, you should have Creative Commons license. Now, what we should not do? We should not select or create learning videos with difficult or complex language. We should not include too many concepts into it. Create or select lengthy videos. We should not use too much of animation because it distracts the participant. Avoid using bright or dull colors and unwanted pictures. The font size could be between 20 to 24. The styles needs to be standard, such as Arial, Calibri, and so on, Verdana, and so on. Avoid using copyright material without reference. So you should always give reference whenever you are using copyright material. To summarize, teacher select the contents. To summarize the out-of-class activity, let us know what the teacher does. Teacher selects the contents, details, decide on the pedagogy, and then either prepare and create or curate the lecture content using various technological tools. The learning videos or handouts are then uploaded on LMS, that is Learning Management System, along with the instructions. The students go through the learning contents, take down the notes and submit the queries, perform activities and submit short assignments based on the concept which you have prepared. The teacher tracks the progress, prepares a list of queries, check the submitted assignment, allot marks and track the progress of students in the out-of-class activity under flipped classroom. Thank you so much. Hope you have understood the topic. To learn more about flipped classroom in-class activities, watch our next learning videos 3.3. For any queries and suggestions, kindly email at pile.dande@gmail.com. Namaste. Happy learning.